Since Spring Data JPA 1.11, which is the Ingalls release, you can automatically publish domain events when an entity object gets saved. You only need to add a method to your entity class that returns a collection of the event objects you want to publish and annotate the method with a domain events annotation. Spring Data JPA calls that method and publishes the events when you execute the save or saveAll method of the entity's repository. Similar to other Spring application events, you can observe them using an event listener or transactional event listener. The main goal of this implementation is to support domain events defined in domain-driven design. These are usually published by aggregate routes and used to inform other parts of your application that an event happened in your business domain. In contrast to other commonly used events, like entity lifecycle events, a domain event should not contain any technical details. You can, of course, publish these events programmatically in your business code using Spring's application event publisher. That's usually the right approach if the event is triggered by a specific business operation and not the change of an attribute's value. But if different business operations cause the same change of an entity object and trigger the same event, using a domain event is easier and less error-prone. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you want to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring Data JPA, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. As mentioned earlier, your entity class has to provide a method annotated with a domain events annotation that returns all events you want to publish. Each event is represented by one object. I recommend using a specific class for each type of event you want to trigger. That makes it easier to implement an event observer that only reacts to a specific type of event. In the example of this video, I want to publish a domain event when a tournament has ended. I created the Tournament Ended Event class to represent this event. It contains the ID of the tournament and its end date. One option to tell Spring Data JPA which events you want to publish is implementing your own method and annotating it with a domain events annotation. In the endTournament method of my chess tournament class, I set the end date of the tournament to now. Then I instantiate a new tournament ended event and add it to the list of events I want to publish when saving the tournament. As you can see here, I also implemented two additional methods. I annotated the domain events method with a domain events annotation and returned the list of events I want to publish. That's the method I mentioned earlier. Spring Data JPA calls it when I call the save or save all method on my chess tournament repository. The after domain event publication annotation on the clear domain events method tells Spring Data JPA to call this method after publishing all events returned by the domain events method. Depending on your observer implementation, this can be before or after your observers handled the event. In this example, I use that method to clear the list of events. That ensures that I don't publish any event twice, even if my business code calls the save method of my chess tournament repository multiple times. Even though you can implement the event publishing yourself, I recommend using another, even simpler option. Spring Data provides the abstract aggregate route class, which provides all these methods for you. You only need to extend it and call the register event method to add your event object to the list. Spring provides a powerful event handling mechanism that's explained in great detail in the Spring documentation. You can observe your domain events in the same way as any other Spring event. In this video, I will give you a quick overview of Spring's event handling features and point out a few pitfalls when working in a transactional context. To implement an observer, you need to implement a method that expects one parameter of the type of your event class and annotate it with event listener or transactional event listener. Let's get into the IDE and give this a try. Spring executes all observers annotated with event listener synchronously and within the transactional context of the event publisher. As long as your observer uses Spring Data JPA, all its read and write operations use the same context as the business code that triggered the event. This enables it to read uncommitted changes of the current transaction and add its own changes to it. In the following observer implementation, I use that to change the ended flag on all chess games of a chess tournament to true and write a short log message. Let's use this event observer and the previously described chess tournament entity in the following test case. It gets a chess tournament entity from the database and calls the entity's endTournament method. It then calls the save method of the tournament repository and writes a log message afterward. You can see in the log output that Spring Data JPA called the event observer when saving the entity. That was a synchronous call that paused the execution of the test case until all observers handled the event. All operations performed by the observer were part of the current transaction. That enabled the observer to initialize the lazily fetched association from the chess tournament to the chess game entity and change each game's ended attribute. If you want to execute your observer at the end of the current transaction, you need to annotate it with transactional event listener instead of event listener. Spring then calls the observer in the defined transaction phase. You can choose between before commit, after rollback, and after completion. By default, Spring executes transactional observers in the after commit phase. Besides the different annotations, you can implement your event observer in the same way as the synchronous observer I showed you in the previous example. In this case, I decide to execute my observer before Spring commits the transaction. This ensures that the observer doesn't block the execution of my test case. When Spring calls the observer, the transactional context is still active and all performed operations become part of the transaction that my test case started. When I execute the same test case as in the previous example, you can see in the log output that Spring calls the observer after my test case performed all its operations, but before Spring commits the transaction. As simple as working with domain events might seem, several pitfalls can cause Spring not to publish an event, not to call an observer, or not to persist the changes performed by the observer. Spring Data JPA only publishes the domain events of an entity if you call the save or saveAll method on its repository. But if you're working with a managed entity, which usually is every entity object you fetch from the database during the current transaction, you don't need to call any repository method to persist your changes. You only need to call a setter method on an entity object and change the attribute's value. Your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, detects the change automatically and persists it. Spring only calls the transaction observers I showed you in the second example if you commit or roll back a transaction. If your business code publishes an event without an active transaction, Spring will not call these observers. If you implement a transactional observer and attach it to the transaction phase after commit, after rollback, or after completion, Spring executes the observer without an active transaction. Due to that, you can only read data from the database, but Spring Data JPA doesn't persist any changes. You can avoid that problem by annotating your observer method with transactional and setting propagation to propagation requires new. That tells Spring Data JPA to start a new transaction before calling the observer and committing it afterwards. When doing that, please keep in mind that the observer's transaction is independent of the one used by the business code that triggered the event. If you attach your event observer to the before commit transaction phase, as I did in one of the previous examples, Spring executes the observer as part of your current transaction. Due to that, you have no guarantee that all changes have been flushed to the database, and you only see the flushed changes if you access the database using the same transaction. To prevent your observers from working on outdated information, you should use Spring Data JPA's repositories to access your database. That's what I did in the examples of this video. It gives you access to all unflushed changes in the current persistence context and ensures that your queries are part of the same transaction. Domain events, as defined in domain-driven design, describe an event that happened in the business domain of your application. Using Spring Data JPA, you can publish one or more domain events when calling the save or saveAll method of a repository. Spring then checks if the provided entity has a method annotated with a domain events annotation, calls it, and publishes the returned event object. You can implement an observer for your domain events in the same way as any other event observer in Spring. You only need a method that expects a parameter of the type of your event class and annotate it with event listener or transactional event listener. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate or Spring Data JPA, make sure to visit persistencehub.com. That is my new membership that gives you access to all my premium video courses, monthly coaching calls, expert sessions, and a community of like-minded developers. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!